Hey, hello everyone. In this video, I'll show you the process of creating this scene I made in Blender 3D. As with every project, the first thing was to look for inspiration and references. It's an important part of laying the foundations for the project. So, take the time you need to gather everything required. In my case, I looked for references for mood, color, lighting, textures, props, and even reallocations. To speed up the process, I use PureRef, a free program where you can throw all your reference images and use them while you work on your projects. It's highly recommended. Check it out. Once we have all the necessary references for our scene, it's advisable to start with the blockout. This is about creating simple shapes to understand the dimensions of our objects and establish the composition before starting to model details or textures. Since some of it's disorganized, I immediately started with the main building, as it would be the hero element of my composition. But this was a mistake, because I had to change the camera position and orientation many times, wasting time and even modeling and texturing elements that ended up being invisible. The actual modeling was pretty easy. I just imported an image as reference, and with transparency, I started adding loop cuts to a plane to match the shape as close as I can. This is simple, lazy Ian Huber tutorial to create buildings. You just add the image and then try to match as close as you can the geometry with loop cuts, and then just extruding, insetting, and moving the faces around. It's really, really, really easy. If you want to learn more of this technique, you can watch Ian Huber's lazy tutorials on buildings. He's one of the greatest Blender artists ever, so yeah, highly recommended too. Then I added some textures to the main building, as I was eager to see how it would look. I downloaded a white brick texture from Blender Kit and edited it to make it more reflective. I also mixed it with a concrete roughness map to make it more varied, and duplicated the original roughness map to use it as a displacement map to create real geometry for the bricks. To make the combini look real, it was essential to make it look packed with stuff. So filling it with gondolas, vending machines, and signs was a must. Using my references, I modeled two types of gondolas and textured them with PBR materials. The modeling was quite simple, just following the references, making some insets, some struts, and done. The vending machines were taken from a pack by Jan Arschel. I'll leave his YouTube channel below in the description, so check it out. This pack helped me a lot. Thanks, Jan. To fill the gondolas in the store, I downloaded 3 models of cereal boxes, bottles, and snack packages from Blender Kit, along with some models of people shopping. I distributed all the products in the gondolas and used the random transform feature to make the product orientations on the Z-axis less uniform. Then, in Photoshop, I designed the prices for each product and added them to a price tag I downloaded from Sketchfab. Thanks, Stella Metal Manufacturers. For the posters that take up much of the store, I downloaded many images from the internet, even generated some with AI, but it was difficult to find the supermarket flyer style I wanted. So I jumped into Photoshop and copied the design of several posters I saw in my references, trying to make them look like authentic Japanese supermarket signs. Then I applied the texture to many signs and scattered them across the store facade and interior. If you're interested in learning more about how I created this scene and many others, I invite you to subscribe to my new Patreon. This way you can support me as a content creator and gain access to exclusive products, including in-depth tutorials on how I created each object in this scene, individual assets ready for use in your own projects, and all kinds of advice and tips on 3D and design in general. And now, let's continue with the exterior of the store. For the exterior, I added some trees from the GeoScatter library to fill the scene background and darken it to focus the attention on the point of interest. I also downloaded several cars and a hippie van from Blender Market to fill the store's exterior. For the sky, I used images as planes with a photo from Kaiwan Chavan's pack. I connected the color to the emission, and that was it. As usual, I created a cube and scaled it to cover the entire scene. I deleted the principal VSDF shader and added a volume shader to create volumetrics. After adjusting the position multiple times, I finally found a camera angle I liked and aligned the main character to the rule of thirds. This way I can create an appealing composition and I think it looks really, really good. I wanted a wet floor to reflect the supermarket lights and make the scene more interesting. To achieve this, I followed Blender Guru's realistic bottles tutorial. If you don't know him, check him out. He's one of the best Blender YouTubers in the world. And I've learned a lot from his videos. He's highly recommended. That's why he's the Blender guru, you know? I also modeled the entrance floor, which unfortunately is almost invisible in the final render. Still, I put a lot of care into making each tile look different and even manually cut each one and extruded some using random select to give it more variation. This is a good technique if you want to avoid using displacement to save render times and VRAM. I also added Quixel Bridge scans to the concrete floor to make real geometry stick out, making it look more realistic and less flat. Lastly, I modeled and textured the trash bin found outside many companies in Japan. After some post-processing in Photoshop, this is the final render. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to leave a comment. Your feedback is much appreciated. If you're interested in a deeper look at how I created each part of the scene, like modeling and texturing the neon sign outside, or the shelves and the trash cans, I invite you to check out my Patreon. Thank you so much, guys, and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.